mercy. They got credit for having done it, just by the blessings. Some great devotee prays to Krishna, please have mercy on this person. So just to please that devotee, Krishna can deliver that person. There's one devotee of Lord Chaitanya, his name is Vasudev Datta. Have you heard of him? And he saw that he had love for God. He was in the Paramananda. But the rest of the people, they were suffering. So he felt very bad. Why should one person get, or few people get all the mercy and so many suffer? Then he said, let me take everyone's. Then we can focus our mind on Krishna. And the more we focus and meditate on Krishna in trance, that means trance is also having very good japa. We chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. We can chant it at one time without distraction. We can go into trance, our heart. Krishna's more pleased. Vara means what? The gate. So this is the gate to mukti. Gate to liberation. Mahat sevam dvaram mahorti mukti. On the other hand, it says about associating with materialistic people. Materialistic people who are in this duality. Their goal in life is how to enjoy the senses. They don't have a higher purpose. So it says such association is tamo dvaram. Tamo means what? So this is the gateway. You go to their house and accept a bowl of milk. So how many of you would like Sukadeva Goswami to come to your house for a glass of milk? Question and send that question. When we go to a holy place, we should ask questions of the saintly people there. But anyway, there's a shortage now of saintly people to provide this information. Srila Prabhupada said he wanted to create a devotees who could fulfill the need of society to get spiritual knowledge and education. Even though we may not all be able to travel,
okay. So, give me the bag so I put everything in the bag. Today, we are in Mathura Desh for special programs with the devotees who are preparing for a feast. We are in one farm. There will be initiation. His Holiness Devataka Swami Maharaj will give initiation after a few hours. Now we have a special program after the Vyasa Puja of the Zoran Jayapataka Swami Guru Maharaj in Mayapur. The work is here. We'd like also to offer their homages for the Vyasa Puja again. This is Jayapataka Swami Guru Maharaj, and things are getting prepared. After that, there will be a special lecture, and then we will have the initiation ceremony.
आपने मुझसे पूछा था आपके हम भ्रमण के बारे में क्या
है.
तो गुरु महाराज ने कहा कि आप चिंता मत
कीजिए.
Also, another thing, what during the past 1 year, I think working on the database of the devotees of Mathura Desh, it is about 70% through, but another 30% is left over. So I wish to complete it by this. And I did all in 3 days, and I would like to offer myself as a pure disciple and set an example.
নাম প্রেমের বন্যা জগতের প্লাবন করে দিয়েছেন, এমনকি মেলোচ্ছ যমুনা পর্যন্ত আপনার শ্রী পাদ পদ্মে আশ্রয় নিয়েছে. আপনার দয়াতে আজ সারা পৃথিবীতে নামের ঢল বয়ে চলছে. পৃথিবীতে সমস্ত দেশ, বাংলাদেশ, ভারত, রাশিয়া আদি সর্বত্র শ্রীল প্রভুপাদের গঠিত ইস্কনের জয় জয়কার হচ্ছে. আর আপনি নিজে গুণে কৃপা করে এই দেশেও মথুরা দেশে নাম রেখেছেন. এই দেশেও অকাতরে কৃষ্ণ প্রেম দান করছেন, যেখানে আজ থেকে নব্বই বৎসর পূর্বে মন্দিরের দূরে মন্দির তো দূরের কথা, কেউ হরিনাম পর্যন্ত করার আশাও করতে পারে নাই, এমনকি হিন্দু পরিচয় পর্যন্ত আত্মগোপন রাখতে হতো. আজ সেই মরুভূমি দেব আপনার অভূতপূর্ব কৃপার প্রভাবে এবং আমার শিক্ষাগুরু শ্রী বিজয় বিনোবা প্রভু এবং শ্রী প্রেমা পদ্মী মাতাজি পরিচালনায় আপনার যে ভক্তি ভিক্ষা নাম হঠ সংঘ সেলফ প্রোগ্রাম দিয়ে, সেই সেলফ প্রোগ্রামের মাধ্যমে এই মথুরা দেশেও অন্যান্য দেশের মতো প্রতি স্থান কৃষ্ণ চৈতন্য মহাপ্রভুর বিলাস. আর অনেক মানুষ কৃষ্ণ ভূমিকে হইতে উঠিয়া কৃষ্ণমুখী হইয়া আছে.
আশীর্বাদ Whatever menial service I am awarded by the Lord, I should do it in the best possible way to please you in your service. Your inspiration and instruction for every one of us to preach and help me, O Lord, is really very nice to preach, which is the only thing which gives worthy and happiness to the heart. By preaching, I am not trying to follow what I am preaching to others. This way, I am also growing, apart from helping and serving others to grow. Thank you, Priyamukhi, for the mercy of sharing the gospel. I beg to you for all the offenses that are committed to your divine grace, Lotus Feet. I beg to you to keep me under the shelter of your Lotus Feet forever and ever. And my service to you today, I am by the mercy of Venugopal Prabhu, Mataji and
Prabhu,
I have been awarded the service of taking care of a cell.
Here it explains we need to hear the glories of the Lord from the spiritual master who is a pure devotee of the Lord, as well as from the pure devotees. But not only should we hear about Krishna, but we should hear about the devotees of Krishna. So in your Vyasa Puja offerings, you are glorifying this humble servant and remembering the words of the Shastra. Vyasa Puja means to worship the Guru as the representative of the entire disciplic succession. So here you have observed this by representing the Guru, by
expecting her to, as a representative of the disciple succession and the whole disciple succession, is worshipped. The Guru is always himself in a mood of a humble devotee of the Lord Chaitanya.
At the
same time, Guru is considered by Shastra as an external manifestation of
Bhagavan.
Just like the post office box. The post office box is not the entire post office,
but it's
connected to the post office.
When
you put your letter in the box, it should go to its destination. Like that, a bona fide guru, by serving him, or by remembering him, or by hearing from him, you're also connected to Krishna. It's important, essential for our spiritual progress. A spiritual master, Prabhupada explained, should be a liberated soul. And there are two kinds of liberated souls. There's a liberated soul like Narada Muni, already has his Sachidananda body, who is fully transcendental. Then there is also a liberated spiritual master who is liberated by serving his spiritual master. By serving a liberated spiritual master. So I'm not claiming to be liberated like Narada Muni. But sincerely trying to serve his divine grace to the AC Bhakti Vedanta Swami. Who certainly is a spiritual master. By serving him, the world will also be liberated. But this is a system.
The
Guru Parampara, to be the servant of the servant of the servant of
Krishna.
Lord Chaitanya, when he was asked his identity, servant of the servant of the servant of Lord Krishna, who is the son of Nanda
Maharaj.
Who is the husband of Krishna, to realize that you need a confirmation from the external guru. The internal guru is Chaitya Guru, is the super soul, Jagannamata. External Guru, Diksha Guru, Diksha Guru. He's confirming what we know from the Chaitya Guru. So we hear the words of the Guru, in our heart we can know that it's true. Because it's being confirmed by the Chaitya Guru. We're having doubts about what the Guru is saying. Then you can ask a question in a submissive way. Prepare by our
doubts.
In this way, by interacting with the spiritual master, we get all our doubts eradicated. When we become free from doubts, free from offenses, then we become a ripened pure
devotee.
This ripening process may take a little less time or may take more time.
हमें लग सकता है
depending on how
sincerely
we try to practice our Krishna consciousness. Just like somebody may take 4 months to take Gopan Asray,
or someone can take 4 years.
It's up to the
individual.
So, the process of ripening is going on.
So
eventually one becomes fully satisfied. When we can satisfy Krishna, then we also become fully satisfied. Let's end here. That Krishna was so pleased with Nidura that he put his lotus feet on the lap of Nidura because Nidura was very meek and gentle. Nidura, of course, he's much older than Krishna. How many of you would like to have Krishna as lotus feet on your lap? Get massage for Krishna's lotus feet. You can't imagine how much mercy. Because Nidura was serving very humbly. Sometimes, Shri Duryodhana had invited Krishna to come and eat at my house to give you a Raj Emperor feast. Already I was invited by Nidura and I had to go to his house. Krishna wasn't caring to eat in the Emperor's house. He's already Lord of Lords. But he wanted to eat his devotees' offering. So when he was taking the offering in Nidura's house, afterwards he would sit and relax. Then he put his feet on Nidura's lap and Nidura would give him massage. At that time Nidura's hair on his body would stand up. His tears would swell in his eyes. So he was very happy at that service. And Atreya, he was happy to narrate the glories of Krishna.
But in narrating
the glories of Krishna, his hands were also standing on him. So these topics about Krishna are fully nectar. The glories may exchange their realizations about Krishna and about Krishna's devotees, pure devotees. And this way they get purified.
और इस तरीके से वो अपने आप को शुद्ध बनाते रहते हैं हमेशा एक दूसरे के साथ प्रश्न करते रहते हैं.
Normally in the material world there are so many discussions.
Do we know
anything about Krishna's glory? Usually. Talking about politicians, talking about sports people, talking about musicians. But here the devotees, they like to talk about Krishna. And Krishna's devotees. Because they are really, truly worshipable. Krishna likes to talk about his devotees.
Krishna bahut zyada bhajan karta hai apne bhakton ke
liye. Hari Das Thakur left the world while Chaitanya was facing him. Before all the brahmanas, and how he ignited the firewood for the sacrifice simply by mantra, by breathing. And all the brahmanas here. How he was preaching door to door with Nityananda. So like this, Lord Chaitanya, this is a pastime of the Lord and His devotee, is to glorify the devotees of the Lord. Prabhupada has made the 4 points. Books are the basis. Preaching is the essence. Purity is the core. Purity is the principle. So when I heard you were speaking today, it seemed like you were saying devotional service is the means. Devotional service is the means. Surrender is the way. Humility is the protection. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare,
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
ग्राम तारिणी पुष्पांजलि सब बैठो
Initiation channel, Madhya Pradesh.
This ceremony is Bhaktami Bhaktako quote Salse Bhagavan ka seva kutti hai aur sab pariksha ke pass ho gaya abhi hari diksha lita hai jab naya naam aur mala grahan karenge mera shishya hoga aur guru parampara asay angame hoga. Also, I'm taking Guru Ashray, Guru Ashray.
ప్రేమాజ శ్రీ రూపానుగ భక్తి శ్రీ గౌరపరుణాచక్తి విగ్రహాయ నమోస్తు
కృష్ణ
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare
derided Lord Chaitanya for being a sentimentalist. Sometimes philosophers criticize the devotees because they think that
Hare Krishna, we are tonight in Bahrain, in Gokul Temple, where the Gaurav Devadatta Maharaj will deliver a lecture in few minutes. Today is 4th of May 2002.
Thank you. Yeah. One who knows what is body and what is soul does not lament for any stage of the body, neither in the living nor in the dead condition. As explained in latter chapters, it will be clear that knowledge means to know matter and spirit, and the controller of both. Arjuna argued that religious principles should be given more importance than politics or sociology. But he did not know that knowledge of matter, soul, and the supreme is even more important than religious formularies. And because he was lacking in that knowledge, he should not have posed himself as a very learned man. As he did not happen to be a very learned man, he was consequently lamenting for something which was unworthy of lamentation. The body is born and is destined to be vanquished today or tomorrow. Therefore, the body is not as important as the soul. One who knows this is actually learned, and for him there is no cause for lamentation, regardless of the condition of the material body. Thus ends the Bhaktivedanta Swami translation purport to the Bhagavad Gita as it is, second chapter, 11th verse, in the matter of contents of the Gita summarized. Hari Om Tat Sat. Giving this knowledge to Arjuna. Do you remember? But the Atma, when does the Atma die?
Never.
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 Does never die. Give her a hand. She knows that. Atma never dies. Only the body dies. Nahanyate hanyamani sarire. Body is dying. Actually, our body is dying every minute, every second. something is dying in the body, when we're young, it's also growing. The process of creation and destruction is going on. As we get older, then just destruction and not much more creation. Decline. So, this process of changing in the body is continually going on. So nothing to lament about. So Arjuna was giving all these big arguments, but he missed a real point. The highest principle in religion is samsiddhim haritoshanam, to please the Supreme Lord. But that he also didn't consider the what was pleasing to Krishna. Many areas that Arjuna had overlooked in his grief. So that this situation happened to Arjuna, that he was put in the Mahamaya by Krishna in order to allow Bhagavad Gita to be spoken. Otherwise Arjuna knew these things. But he was made to forget in order to have the Bhagavad Gita spoken. Sometimes Krishna has his devotee made an example in order to teach others. Parikshit Maharaj also had the Bhagavatam spoken to him. So he was made an example. Brahmananda Prabhu, he tells about something that happened in 1960s, maybe 6 or 67 in New York Temple. That time everyone was very new. They don't know what is etiquette. So when Srila Prabhupada walked into the back of the temple, that entrance is in the back and deities are in the front, then everyone faced to Prabhupada and offered him their obeisances. So they are pointing their feet to the deity. So there are so many people there. The Prabhupada had a walking stick. He reached over someone and he hit on the rear end Brahmananda Prabhu and said, "Why are you facing your feet to the deity?" His natural ego reaction was, why? To facilitate the devotees to get the spiritual understanding. All these principles are very simple, but the simple things we miss. Just like sometimes people ask us, what are you doing to stop the wars in the world? So many wars are being caused by religion. So what are you doing to stop it? But actually this Krishna conscious philosophy, where the Bhagavad Gita's philosophy that we are not this body. If we truly understand it, and the people around the world understood it, then this type of sectarian violences and sectarian wars shouldn't be there at all.
Today, May 5th, 2002, His Holiness Jayapataka Swami Guru Maharaj is giving a lecture to a small group of devotees in Goful Temple, Bahrain, Balaram Desh.
Satya yukto vicharati
Goraya Bhagavan Bhava Nidura asks Maitreya, my dear Brahmana, why did the Pachetas meet Lord Shiva on the way? Please tell me how the meeting happened, how Lord Shiva became very pleased with them, and how he instructed them. Certainly such parts are important, and I wish that you please be merciful upon me and describe them. The great sage Vidura continues, all best of the Brahmanas. It is very difficult for living entities engaged within this material body to have personal contact with Lord Shiva. Even great sages who have no material attachments do not contact him, despite their always being absorbed in meditation to attain his personal contact. Lord Shiva, the most powerful Deva, second only to Lord Vishnu, is self-sufficient. Although he has nothing to aspire for in the material world, for the benefit of those in the material world, he is always busily engaged everywhere and is accompanied by his dangerous energies like Goddess Kali and Goddess Durga. Report by Srila Prabhupada. Lord Shiva is known as the greatest devotee of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. He is known as the best of all types of Vaishnavas. Vaishnavanam Yatha Sambhu. Consequently, Lord Shiva, as the Vaishnava Sampradaya, the disciplic succession known as the Rudra Sampradaya. Just as there is the Brahma Sampradaya coming directly from Lord Brahma, the Rudra Sampradaya comes directly from Lord Shiva. Lord Shiva is one of the 12 great personalities as stated in Srimad Bhagavatam 6.3.20. Svayam Purnarada Sambhu Kumara Kapilo Svalado Tanako Vishmo Valirvayasakir Vayam. These are 12 great authorities in preaching God consciousness. The name Sambhu means Lord Shiva. His disciplic succession is also known as the Vishnu Swami Sampradaya. And the current Vishnu Swami Sampradaya is also known as the Vallabha Sampradaya. The current Brahma Sampradaya is known as the Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya. Even though Lord Shiva appeared to preach Mayavad philosophy at the end of his pastime in the form of Sankara Acharya, he preached the Vaishnava philosophy.
Govindam 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 Mudamati.
He stressed worshipping Lord Krishna or Govinda three times in his verse, and especially warned his followers that they could not possibly achieve deliverance or mukti simply by word jugglery and grammatical puzzles. If one actually is serious to attain mukti, he must worship Lord Krishna. This is Sripada Sankara Acharya's last instruction. Herein it is mentioned that Lord Shiva is always accompanied by his material energy, Satya.
Yedo yedo yami na do narsimha.
Thank you for watching our videos. Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day, and don't forget to like and share our channel.